you so very much. I am honored to be here. I took my first plane yesterday and previous. So, like, to be in a room with brilliant artists and colleagues was really exciting. So, I'll just be honest. Yeah, so let's get to the next. July 27th, 2008, was my first day at Kendra Scott, and I was so thrilled to have a full-time job doing all of the things I loved. One more thing was education, doing graphic design, photography, to myself. Absolutely thrilled. I came under very small, female-oriented, only female-oriented team. And what was amazing about this is that a lot of us didn't I had a German language opportunity from the University of Texas at Austin. Kendra is a cultural. So, the cool part about this was that it gave us a sense of freedom. Anything was possible in my mind because, well, we didn't know the rules, so we didn't prescribe the rules. Brilliance in the making, or blind ignorance, you know, but above. But most importantly, we just simply had entrepreneurial spirit. We worked together. We trusted God. We iterated. We reiterated to try to find what was working for the business. And we had an entrepreneur's dream here. While she would consider herself a designer, she was going to say, she had a top box, she had two stores to generate some pictures. She was selling products for 5 years to anybody and everybody, as well as finding ways to give back to people that were suffering from Philanthropy. So she found a way to use that journey to give back. But she did it. She forced me to see a boy that lived in Italian when she was at school in 2002. She wanted to see a kid. What do you think that means in running a business differently? Three things that were the absolute most important for her experience in building her business was to surround yourself with people that held the same vision. To surround yourself with people who support that excellent vision. To be able to do what you love, because it gives you strength as an entrepreneur. You're able to do that and create that. And then create the space for others to do the same. And then to give back. Where is it from to end another way in your life? These fundamentals, those three fundamentals, are core questions for many people who are crucial things. But they became our collective values, which are really the questions. Don't click twice in the comments. If not, it's bigger than what you take into the place of the building. So, as we sit, as the statement is, I swear I'm never going to go to retail. Don't have to see that I think it's going to be fun. I'm going to figure this out. But absolutely, we want to go to retail. Well, especially now. We were also, during the recession, really trying to figure out how to get that direct connection with our customer. Because we were at wholesale versus the 600 times. We had to go to retail. And it wasn't working. We were having to go through them to get to our people, and it was just tiny steps. And so we actually, in the recession, the first step was to open the first showroom online, to gain that access, direct access, and gain that relationship most importantly. And then in 2010, got ready for a little bit more detail, we took an idea and concept that we had originally launched and handed it up to our New York City Coca-Cola. Where our customers, and their customers were allowed to play design, have fun interaction, and create a style that was whatever they chose, underway when, in the truth, we realized the color line. And that was our digital first way to contact the digital world. And it led to hell. We need to get into retail. And all of this is happening at the same time, right? 2008, 2010, November 2010, we were freshman year. And we wanted to create these things. We wanted to reach our businesses again. We've got to do it differently. We have got to pull out our customers to have the most fun to reach them. Once we get them in the store, we want them to stay. We want them to stay and play and have fun. So the whole color line became central to our storytelling and our community. Some of the other more important pieces of the puzzle. Product is amazing, giving your customer something that they want to come and do is amazing. But we also want to philosophically not have a loop for our customer experience. So we wrote our work here, customer service philosophy, the founded on the system we're building. It's really simple, really basic. If a sensory rubber walks into the room, you would go out and do it to take care of one's life. Meaning, empowering every individual, every single employee, no matter what team holder, manager, right, customer service associate, have to come up to the team. That's what it was. Go out and do it to take care of one's life. So everyone who walks into this, into the door, has a family member. How that empowers the individual, but also created the space of welcoming and warmth is everything for us. So when we got into this way of retail, we didn't want to run a customer, we wanted to be a sweet direction, someone who knows if you really walk away, but fundamentally, this is truth. And we wanted to take a stand up retail, especially in the retail, as an enterprise or brand that has both fashion and design. We wanted to kind of take all the glass pieces away, take away the scary from the brand. We have open cases, we listen to the actual signs, and then we start with the first one. But I made signs at the top front of the house to encourage individuals to really take away the touch this and allow me to play. We're just like, wow, Jordy's fine! Jewelry's such expressive. And how many people in this room have bought jewelry as a gift for someone else? How many people in this room have received a gift from someone else? Oh, it's a gift. You deserve more. You deserve more and you deserve better. So, we have this amazing product that has created amazing experiences. And that's when we opened our first one. We also have a line up there today. And we're going to keep it going. Because we didn't know how to do that. And a lot of people came back to us and said, wow, thank you so much for participating in my child's school. You've donated here at the school. Thank you. We have so many people from our community. It's been our philosophy that someone asks for something, we would always like to have to walk. And so we became known as a brand that would care. So we had a following without knowing that that's exactly what we're doing. So when we did that, we got all the things like certain secret sauces that added to this. How do we expand? We have an infrastructure that is set with a fundraising working team that is dedicated and has been dedicated since 2008 to develop programs for communities. We hosted 14,000 events last year alone in our stores. 10,000 degrees of candidates and events. You don't have to be a better way to do it on the host event in our store. getting back and getting engaged with our customers and their communities is foundational to us in their relationships. One of the big roles we have in our group is our retailer. Retail engineer that helps shut the door. Where to go? Our entire fleet at one point was shut down. And as an experience of this, that was simply the sacrifice of the entire So we held together, my first time in the street, we held together, for providing a baseline for us to do virtual trial sessions, to host virtual contributor sessions, and we just bring that back to the virtual platform and into the virtual space. What's amazing is those programs are so powerful from us that we don't do that. It is exciting that we're able to connect to our customers. Thank you. say, I'm offering, but when I get a piece of steak, when it's in this brand new one, I think it's steak, it just comes along. Does he ever make more? And that's the problem with the rates. Within the past couple of years, it's always been difficult. Within the past couple of years, it's been totally difficult, even more to pay for something that we have to rent, to provide even more value for the customers. Then, how do we continue to provide this really cool experience? This color registration. Does anybody just who knows what the color? So one of the ways, I guess, the first of this work is bar, but high, sedentary, but it's the second new entrance there. It's always the place where you want people to help on the sideline. You bring your best girlfriends, your bachelorette party, to talk to some pieces together. And creating that community experience for your personal customers to come in and help on the sideline. Service. They actually love sitting down with our customers because we deliver them the day. And then we get to know them even better what actually matters to them. We can say, hey, we're here for you and your community. And so we're going to tell you to do stuff about your story. How can we participate? How can we make a way to you? Because we have not only, we don't only give back, but we roll our sleeves. We have a culture of giving with why. Thank you. Thank you. with all the last conference, Kendra Scott, and others who have been in the conference, I think we'll get a little bit better. But in English, we think we do what others do best do. And, you know, when you're on the social media too, you never expect to have a great time on the last day of college. But always, the way that you can go to the city that it comes to town, and there's a lot of change, there's a lot of change happening, and organically, things forget. So our team gathered together for things like, what if somebody, Wednesday morning, we put together a real, same story, best, better way to do it. And from there, the conversation took off. We did that magical first time. So we leaned into the strategy and the five-step strategy and we started everything we had. We started with inclusive game day was what we always said, so we tried to make it into the different sports, joy, if you will, went to best team, the best fan, best best fan. But we speeded it up. Leading into our gyms, and that's what we saw with the background of gyms, college gyms, and what went best. And we leaned in, so recruitment, events, we led them in the direction of talking about recruitment. So this morning, we went into multi-day, everyday training outfits, and we provided them with some intervention that we really wanted, and now it's what we see, three of the pieces that we
What's your bubble gum?
We have
hand sanitizer.
Where are we to stand up, Joe?
Woo! Here,
congratulations. Thank you, Kendra. That was awesome. Kendra, we did not get rid of you back with this. We have some questions for you.
Oh,
that's good. If you want to avoid questions, just give a gift. Thank you just so much for doing that. Does anyone have any questions? So, if you want to learn about what you're doing, it's like, what was the people to do?
For the next 3 days, after we ask questions, you just let us know who you are. Thank you.